University life has never felt so different. Amidst the coronavirus pandemic, many things have changed. From ordering food online, to online classes, to masks having to be worn all around campus. There are a lot of things students might have considered alien not even 1 year ago. Testing is another new part of what the university has been doing in response to the virus.
We've now moved into the asymptomatic, meaning individuals who have no symptoms, are going to be tested on a regular basis. And we've developed a model which allows us to test the right amount of students to be able to pick up signals for COVID activity on campus. And so the way that works is we're going to be testing 15% of residential undergraduates. We'll be testing 25% of non-residential undergraduates. And we'll be testing 15% of all graduate students, and most of those are non-residential.
According to Dr. Hill, students so far have done well with testing and adhering to university protocols. Better yet, since the last testing cycle, no new cases have been reported. But with testing set to go on for the rest of the semester, it needs to be done right. Students have spoken on the current state of testing and what they've judged it to be so far.
When I went to get tested randomly last week, the line was, it wasn't bad at all. I was in and out, so I think that overall the testing is really, really good.
They give you all the instructions that you need to do, and it's really very, very quick and harmless, so glad I can get it done, you know, without any stress.
I think testing is going really well. I've been tested twice. I had the pre-arrival test, and then I had the test when I arrived on campus within the first 24 hours, and I think every week, 15% of the population is being tested, and two of my suite mates have already been tested. So I think overall, it's going really well.
As another precaution, students must also download a symptom checking app in order to update symptoms of the virus on a daily basis. The purpose is meant to help prevent contact between students and health center employees, while also providing a means for students to report their conditions for better tracking of the virus. But with the precautions in place, students' good behavior, and a healthy dose of optimism, there is hope in the university becoming a beacon of safety and planning for future dangers to come.
I think things are going great. I think the whole community has come together. That's the message. Quinnipiac is a special place. I think there is this sense of community, and everybody's in this together.
For Q30 News, I'm Luca Triant.